All right, in continuance. Hurry, hurry, quick, we have to coordinate the Ballet Embassy, the dancing embassy, the dance embassy for Europe, my gosh, we need a telephone number that works, that is supplied and available. Who wants to be starting the telephone? Because it has to be a telephone personnel. Before I get through all of this discussion, I want to still entice you with 100 of the dancers, the former dancers, for 20,000 each month, 20,000 from the division of the European Union. For 20,000 each month, we supply ourselves with housing, very cheap housing, and I mean it. It will not be anything that hurts. If anything, it'll be like, what? We need double, but we should be fine. We should be fine with such a low amount at the beginning. I believe so. I believe it's. So yeah, so you can have 20 people for 4,000 a month as a rent. You can have 100 people at 20,000 a month as a rent. Now, if you are going to be the donator, if you're going to donate to the Ballet of Europe, to all of the dancers from the former state opera houses, if you're going to be a person who donates, I don't want you to be thrown in with the European Union owning of it. So that has to be a different department. It has to be a department of real estate that is not concluded with the ownings of the European Union. So you can donate freely without feeling like it's going into the state of the European Union. So, because we don't want to stop people from donating, because they can definitely, at their last moments, go, hey, let's go for it. But who do we contact? My last knowledge, there was Sandor Nemethy, as ballet master, director of Austria. Now, I danced with him for not a long time, but I danced with him, and I believe he has the capacity of what do we call it, believability, the believability capacity that he is known as a major important player in the dance world of Europe. So because he is such an important, I'll call him a demigod. I guess he is one to contact, isn't he? He is one to contact, and he is one to already start donating. I would already, if I had the money and the houses, I would already have donated them to him. Because when I think of somebody who stayed in the dancing and been there and been a pure thespian of the art the entire time, dedicated and working on all levels, even teaching, even ballet master, even, gosh dang it, rehearsals and probas, all of this. If I think of anybody who's been there the entire time and been quite secure with that, it has been him. He has not been a flouncer dancing around from this company to this company to this company. He's been quite staid in one company or another, so he's quite stable in that respect of his person. So I would think as a coordinator for money and finances, if you want to donate, he would be the one to find as being our one of our leaders. He is one of our leaders of this time of European dance companies. He is one of the leaders. As a person that you can just call, well, you can't just call him, but yeah, a person to contact. We have to figure out a way to have him be the, I don't know, what do you call him? The principal. I want him to be the principal of the situation, one of the main principals, like a board of directors. I want him to be a main board of directors. So, when I think of other nominees, I've only danced really very much in Germany, and I don't have that many to nominate. I have some very proud dancers that I would nominate, but I can't remember their full name, and so I feel like an idiot. Virgil, I would nominate Virgil. Virgil from Mannheim. He was a very stable performing artist that I would know already. That his speaking, his language skills for the East are very important part of the embassy. Okay, so yeah. So he would be another one. Gosh dang it. What's Virgil's last name? Anybody know or anybody remember? Real big tall Virgil. I danced with Nadia, Nadezhda there. So yeah. He would be a formidable, gosh dang it, and all the time dedicated diehard, I'll say, of the dance. You know, so this is what we're looking at. We're looking at these types of people, drumming them up. People have been, and I can't say that you can't even call on me. I'm just a what do we call me at this point? I can't even use to see on these videos. I'm pretty weak. I'm pretty weak for my current state. I'm not. I'm dizzy. I'm dizzy. And so at this point in time, it's difficult for me to actually be a hostess of everything, and say, hey, claim me even as a board of director, even though it is me selling it as the big idea. I think in retrospect, when people are showing up with money and saying, hey, this is my last will and testament, I'm going to give you some cash out. I'm going to give housing for the dancers. Here I have a hotel. You can have my hotel. When I'm saying these types of things, no, they're not going to want to be giving to me. They're going to want to be giving to the people who have been the absolute stability. The stability of the dance for many, many years. I can't really call on women, I'm sorry. I can't call on women because I know you're all, I don't know, in some other place sometimes. I just can't call on the women. I would call on Alessandra Ferry, but I don't know if she's up for it. I would call on a few that are really, really... maybe they're bored, they've gone into retirement now and they're just bored and they just need to do something else. There's Sylviane Bayard. I call on Sylviane. Okay, now Sylviane, she was their director of the Germany, of the Berlin. Now, I know she was director of there and it was a very tedious time and there was a lot of firings. And so she, in retrospect, is one person who would be absolutely behind all of this, knowing that these dancers have been thrust out into the streets. And they don't have a normal vocation, and their heart has been pretty much wretched out, just from that one firing time. So she definitely will be a supporter of the embassy and all of its workings. That would be, I think 80 dancers were fired under her tutelage. So we're not gonna ever forget that Sylviane will be a helper. I believe, if anything, she is already a voice through me right now in calling this action. That when that type of thing goes on, and we lose that many dancers all at once, just because of a changeover of directorships, intendants, or money flow, No, we have our responsibility. We have a responsibility to those dancers. We have a responsibility to many of the dancers that get caught up in these types of ridiculous situations. So yes, so Sylviane Bayard, I believe she's a teacher in France, enseignée, a ballet mistress somewhere in France, but I'm not sure. But yeah, I would put her on the board. I'm not running through the Prix de Lausanne list for who's on the board or who isn't on the board, but yeah, we need a varied mixture of persons, and we will be speaking strange English. I imagine so, more than German. I believe it will be more of a strange English. So please feel free to start thinking of other names. Those are my three hotties at the moment that I'm not going to list Pierre Wies, even though he is a dedicated choreographer many, many years. I'm not going to list him as being a have-to contender. I know he has lots of dancers, you know, at his name call, but I don't really think that's really what he wants to do. So we'll leave him out of it, and he could be someone you can tap into or contact rather, but you know, as a coordinator type of person, no, I don't think that would be something he wants to do. I think. No, yeah, it's strange, isn't it? Some people really have the head for the choreography, and they just want to choreograph, you know, that's their life, and nothing else. And this is something kind of office-y, you know what I mean? Office-y. So I'm just trying to find the 50 people that are important people of dance right now in Europe. And I want those 50 people to be members of the Ballet Embassy. Now, so just think of these persons right away, and we'll tantalize again with the number, you know, for 4,000 a month, that's 20 people. It's 20 people with 200 each a month. It's only 200 each. To live, you know, so we can find places that are approximately that size, or even larger. It's like a company again, isn't it? It's kind of like a company feeling. It's like getting back into a company. It doesn't have to be that way. You know, we're just going to be doing other things. We're still going to be working for the opera houses, because we're still going to be supplying things, you know, that they need, graphic arts, whatever. We're still going to be working for them. A little bit here, a little bit there, but it's not going to be anything like you know, you have to go out there and do your fortes. I'm not telling you anything like this, but I'm too tempted. Yeah, I know. I did not for too long. So I'm too tempted. So I'm become an idiot. I've become an idiot at the retry. Sometimes, yeah. I don't know. So we're looking for people who are dedicated and who have been in the dance world very many years in Europe as stability factors. I would also call on Franz. His name is Franz, from Switzerland. I'm not sure his last name, okay, all right. So that's where I'm at. That's where I'm at right now. Is I'm trying to drum up. Because this is going to be people, you know, who are giving housing to us, people who are actually giving us a formative retirement. You know, so once after the dance, we can still contribute, we can still belong, we can still belong to the theaters. That's really all it's about. We just still have to belong, you know what I mean? We're just diehards for having to be longing, you know, into it. And so we're not just these strangers out there that throw mud at the wall, you know, angry. You know, so we're still belonging, you know? Yeah.